By the end of this video, you'll have a Facebook and Instagram shop and be ready to start selling your products online. Let's dive in. Before you can get started selling your products on Facebook or running ads, there's a couple of things that you'll need. First is a business manager account with full admin access. If you already have an existing e-commerce store, you will want to have the backend login access to your e-commerce website. It would be good to know what e-commerce platform you're selling on and also which specific pixel is connected to that e-commerce site. If you don't already have an e-commerce store and you're starting from scratch, that's okay. We're gonna walk you through all the steps and you'll be able to get fully set up through this tutorial as well. So what is Facebook Commerce Manager? This is for businesses that are actively selling on Facebook and Instagram platforms. Without a Commerce Manager account, you cannot run certain types of ads and you also will not be able to set up a Facebook or Instagram shop. Commerce Manager can be used for physical, but also digital product sellers as well. The first thing we're gonna do is log in to our Business Manager or Business Suite account and navigate to Business Settings. Once you're inside of Business Settings, you should see a dropdown for accounts. You should be looking for something that says Commerce Manager. If you do see that tab, it looks like you may have already started this process in the past. However, it's still gonna be better for us to all start from scratch in Catalogs, which is going to be under the Data Sources tab. Once I'm on Catalogs, I'm gonna see the option to create a new catalog. You may also see other catalogs in there from the past, but again, start from scratch. I'm gonna click Add and create a new catalog. I'm then gonna give my catalog a name. This is only gonna be something that you see and should represent the products that will go in this catalog. In the dropdown, it will allow you to select the type of products that you're selling. If you're selling digital products, I would simply leave it on products. The next screen will allow you to set permissions. Just because something was created inside of a business manager account does not mean that everyone has access to it. You should select everyone on the left-hand side that should be able to access or use this catalog in any way and give them full admin access by turning on the Manage Catalog toggle. If you see anything that says Conversions API, Shopify API, go ahead and select those as well. The next tab is going to allow me to connect a pixel to this specific catalog. You should double check you know the pixel that's on your current e-commerce website or simply the pixel that you plan on using for this e-commerce store. If you connect this catalog to the wrong pixel, you will not see the results that you're looking for. If you are not sure from that prompt which pixel is yours, don't worry. Click the X to close the dialog box, and we're then gonna see a button that says Associate Sources on the catalog tab. That will also allow us to select the connected pixel and also just gives you a little bit more information so that you can verify you're selecting the correct one. The next step is to click the button on the far right that says Open in Commerce Manager. Now that you're in Commerce Manager, you want to click on the top right-hand side button that says Add Items. The first will be to manually add products. The second will be to upload through a spreadsheet. A spreadsheet will allow to have more control over the inventory that's shown so that someone doesn't purchase something that's been out of stock. This also can be helpful if you simply have all of your product data in a spreadsheet already. If you already have an active e-commerce site, we can do a sync with a third-party e-commerce provider like Shopify, WooCommerce, or BigCommerce. The last option is to do this through the pixel, where the pixel data will pull in the products from your site. This can be a little bit more advanced and you may need a developer for this. So for this video, we're going to mention how to do this with your third-party integration, as well as how to add products manually. Now we're gonna click on manual and I'll show you how to add these products one by one. Once we're on this screen, you will already see the very first line item. All you need to do is go through each column and update the information to fit your product, upload the image, add the price, and it's already active. Once you're done with the first product, you can add the second, and so on and so forth. If you're enjoying this video so far, stop and do me a favor and hit that like button. Now, I'm gonna show you how to sync your product catalog with an existing e-commerce store. This depends greatly directly on the platform that you're currently using to host your products. However, virtually all of these options are done in the back end of your website through a plugin, add-on, or something within that e-commerce platform. It will give you those instructions once you select your specific e-commerce provider. Let's go ahead and add these products through our third-party integration. Select the right third-party e-commerce platform you're using and follow the prompts that it provides to you. You'll go through and select the specific assets that you'll be connecting to this account. Double check and make sure that those assets, such as the business manager, the Facebook page, the pixel, and the catalog you just created, were all the correct assets. You may run into an issue where certain items are grayed out or say ineligible. While there are different reasons for these things, the most common is that those assets are not existing within the same business manager account, or you as a person do not have access to those assets. Adding access through the partner tab in business manager is the easiest way to overcome that. If you're not sure how to do that, don't worry. We've got a link to a video in the description below. You'll then give your new commerce account a name, and then it's gonna have you verify all the information you just input or selected. Make sure to double check that and click continue. Once you've gone through all those prompts, it should redirect you back to your site and instruct you on how to sync those products. This will be done in the back end of your current e-commerce website. Once that's been completed, hop back over to Business Manager and we will set up that commerce account. Whether you added your products manually or synced them with your third-party platform, double check that your items are inside of your catalog by going under the catalog tab and clicking on items. Once you've done that, let's hop over to the overview tab so we can finish setting up this commerce account. We should see at the top of the page the option to customize your shop. Clicking on customize your shop will allow you to add collections or groupings of products, or you can leave it as is and simply hit publish. And because I used a third-party e-commerce integration where checkout on another website is already the default checkout method, I am ready to start selling in my Facebook and Instagram shop. However, I will not be able to allow people to pay directly through Facebook and Instagram. My shop will simply link my items to the product page on my site for someone to check out as they normally do. Let's go in and find out how to set up Facebook and Instagram checkout so that you also make this a much more frictionless experience for someone purchasing from you. Once you click to get started with Facebook and Instagram checkout, you are redirected to an article about how to become eligible for this account. But go ahead, look through that, go through the steps and start that process so you can be approved. Once you have done that, you will then need to go back to your shop or your commerce account and fill in some additional details. If you are already eligible, you're simply gonna follow the prompts in your Commerce Manager overview section, such as setting up your shipping details, your return details, and finally, your payout information. Because this is actually handling those transactions, it needs your business and bank account information to be able to deposit the funds that are being transacted upon. Go ahead and try and get them so that you can be approved and verified as soon as possible. If you do go through those steps, you may still encounter a wait time. Either way, there is no better time than right now to start this process. If you have gone through the steps to enable your Facebook and Instagram checkout, go ahead and click publish shop now and you'll be ready to sell. Now that you've created your catalog, your commerce account, and you're ready to sell, it's time to create our ad. We are gonna hop over to Ads Manager and click create. Once we've created that campaign, we're going to need to choose a conversion objective. In this case, we are gonna be selecting catalog sales. Once you do that, you can give your ad set a name and your ad a name and go ahead and click next to go through all of the different details at the campaign, ad set, and ad level. What you want to do is double check that the catalog in the dropdown is in fact the catalog that you've just created that has those most recent products inside. Once we're on the ad set level, there are two specific things that you'll want to check on that are not present when you create other types of campaigns. The first would be the product set dropdown. This is more like that collection that you created in your shop that you would like to advertise in this ad. If you just want to promote all of your products, that's fine. Leave that empty or as the default option. Go through and select the budget that you would like, as well as the placements. But when you get to the audience tab, you have two different options. Retarget people who have engaged with your products on Facebook, and another says expose your brand to audiences who may not have engaged with you yet. If you select the retargeting option, it will give you a list of additional options, such as what the time window is going to be, if you would like to promote specific cross-sells or upsells. However, those will be based on your product sets. Make sure that you create those product sets inside your catalog and link them to be recognized as a cross-sell or an upsell. Once you've selected your budget and your audience, hop over to the ad level to actually set up our ad. You will want to verify that Facebook page and Instagram account are in fact the same that are connected to your commerce account and your catalog. If they are not the correct pages, you will not see the products that you uploaded in your ad. You're going to scroll down and have the same creative options you would typically have: video, single, image, as well as carousel. For this example, I have used the carousel option. Beneath that, we will see a multiple products option so that I can have various products within this single carousel. The next option you'll see is carousel cards. These are dynamic and they are based on what someone is engaging with related to your products. Finally, you will edit the text in your carousel or your ad copy, add your primary URL. Make sure that you use URL parameters to ensure the most accurate tracking. The final section will be tracking. You want to make sure that the pixel selected in the dropdown is the correct pixel for this catalog, this commerce account, and this business. Everything looks good. You can hit publish and you are good to go and ready to sell. Once your ads are up and running, you want to continue to optimize them to get better results in your Facebook and Instagram shop. Hop over to this playlist to learn exactly how to do that.